I witnessed something today in Panera Bread, and this is one of those comedy stories that sounds like a setup, but it actually happened at 2 o'clock today in the DuPont Circle Panera Bread. I was in there to get a bagel, because I, when I'm depressed and working the road, I have breakfast at 2:15 in the afternoon. So I was in there, and I realized, I'm 35, and I realized there's a real generational gap. Like, I think 35 is the new 60. In terms of whose values and whose way of approaching life I more resemble. Because to me, the people 25 and under might as well be dead to me. Very stupid. They're buried in their iPhone. I hope they all get hit by cars when they're texting in America. No, you're rude. You're fucking narcissistic, rude fucks. If you're God! Why should I get out of your way just because you're fucking texting? Move. I will truck you like Ray Lewis across the fucking middle. And then just go, no penalty. You weren't even fucking looking. You were too busy texting about happy hour. But, so one of these, it's like 23-year-old chick is on the phone. Like, I know, right? And this old guy, like 60 plus, who looked like he was like in a war of some kind at some point. Like, or maybe just real angry. He might have just been an angry dude. The person announces behind the counter, Timothy, mac and cheese. And he goes like slowly in his, you know, I killed teenagers in Vietnam kind of walk to the counter. And iPhone bitch just grabs it. And then he taps her on the shoulder. He goes, he kind of said, I think sarcastically, he was like, are you Timothy? And she goes, what? And he said, mac and cheese. He's like, yeah, but he said for Timothy. And he takes it. And she goes, okay, fuck, whatever. Like, relax. Take your mac and cheese. And he did this move. And I'm watching the whole thing. He did this. And then she said, relax. And he went. And at that moment, I said, hit the bitch! About me, which I didn't want. I wanted to keep it in, but it was, I swear to God, it felt like one of those moments in like No Country for Old Men when you think a character's gonna kill another person, and at that moment he just reconsidered, like he turned like he was a gunslinger, he's about to just put one right between her fucking eyes. I was like, come on! But he didn't.